The second half of the NHRA Mission Foods Drag Racing Series in 2024 begins in the most majestic and beautiful of settings that we see all year long. The Pacific Northwest is a great place in the city of Seattle, a great example of its culture, and certainly of its incredible beauty. We are here at the NHRA Northwest Nationals at Pacific Raceways in Kent, Washington, among thousands of rabid NHRA drag racing fans that are set to see some of the highest performing automobiles we have seen all season long in some of the most oxygen-rich conditions of the year. And the two cars thundering down the drag strip, it is Doug Coletta. Coletta 367, 330, 741. The fastest speed in the history of this drag strip by some 2 miles an hour and the low ET of the entire race so far. A thunderous effort here by Coletta and crew. Caps has problems. They're both pedaling Caps's car. Wounded and blows the body off. A massive explosion for Caps and he fights for control. Gary Densham will advance, but a bad explosion at the top end. You could see the mixed up cylinders, Tony. That one was bound to do exactly what it did. Went off like a nuke. And he will fight out of round one as Green's car shuts off early. Bob Tasca goes 386.8, 338.51 miles an hour for Bob Tasca III. One of the fastest runs in the history of NHRA funny car drag racing. And Dave Richards is sideways across the racetrack and hard into the right-hand retaining wall. Richards, a very bizarre launch, 389.1 at 327 miles an hour for Matt Hagen. Clean. You can see Dave's brother very dispirited on the starting line as Richards will drive the car down the racetrack. A bizarre situation here for Richards. It's an in-car look here for Dallas Glenn, the Summit Racing Equipment on board. Dallas Glenn, 200s better than his boss. How is he at the finish line? Dallas Glenn wins in a hole shot. By 0.007 of a second, he pulled a rug out from under Greg Anderson. 6.52.8 beats a 6.51.4. Harford's car did the same thing it did in round one. It began to creep ahead. This time, though, it sunk his battleship as he gets to the finish line behind Dallas Glenn and he loses on a hole shot. A 6.59 beats a 6.56. And whether it was a mechanical fault or not, Hartford's car was creeping at the starting line. Glenn's wasn't. And the two cars off the starting line. Coletta's car hazes the tires, and at the finish line stripe, it is Torrence, 373.6 at 330 miles an hour. A calendar year since his last victory here in Seattle. He's back in the final round. A crew chief tandem of young Johnny Lindbergh and experienced John Medlin tuning for Paul Lee. Lee took a pretty big bite on the starting line. Staged the car pretty deep. Alexander hazes the tires, and for the first time in his career, Paul Lee is heading to a Nitro Funny Car Top Fuel Final. 399.8 at 324 miles an hour. This has been a dream of this guy's life since he was a kid at Atco Dragway in the 70s in his mom's Slant 6 Duster. Unfortunately, Matt Smith has had to climb off his Denso motorcycle. It failed to start in his matchup against Chase Van Sant. The final round will be Chase Van Sant and Gage Herrera, the two hot-blooded and very talented young riders in this category. 6.89 at 1.97 for Van Sant, a slower run than likely he planned to make. He may have shut it down early per his crew chief. So you can see the disappointment for Smith. It wouldn't fire. They had the starter plugged in. They were spinning the engine over. Would not ignite. Tony, it can be an ignition problem. Usually it's the crank sensor or something like that. Thank you. They lead. Van Zandt 17. Gage Herrera is 0-25.
He's quicker on the track.
It looks like he might have enough. And at the finish line, stripe, it's Chase Van Zandt. The streak ends in 11 races. 672 at 201 miles an hour by 43 thousandths of a second. And that is how you get a first career win.
Well, Chase Van Sant has in his hand what he has longed for, want for all too long. You did what seemed to be the unthinkable here today. You beat that unstoppable force in Gage Herrera. Not only did you beat him on the track, but on the tree. Congratulations.
Thank you. It's unreal. You know, Jerry Savoie told me I was going to win one of these things, and he said when I did, I was going to cry. So, Jerry, I'm sorry. I'm fighting it back, but I'm not going to do it. Man, I can't thank this team enough, the whole White Alligator Racing team. I mean, Jerry for giving me the opportunity, Tim Kalungian for allowing me to be out here and all his hard work, Keith Nichols, man, you're the man. You absolutely work his butt off to make this motorcycle go fast. Man, my dad, Trick Tools, Transfluid, Ready Parts. Man, JC Speed Shop, this is just unreal. I can't believe it.
Congratulations. Let it soak in.
Thank you.
Green lights on both sides of the tree. 8:010 reaction time for Jeg Coughlin. And at the finish line stripe, it is a win for Jeg Coughlin. A third on the season. 6:53.6 at 2:09. Marginally outrunning the 6:54.1. But this is a guy who now, for the 68th time, has won in pro stock with a 10 reaction time.
It is all smiles down here for the natural. Your pro stock winner, the 68th. Of your career, Jeg Coughlin. You grew up in a racing family where this is what you guys did. Did you ever dream you were holding 68 of those?
Yeah, no doubt. You know, in total, counting the sportsman wins, it's 87, I think, this week, which is unfathomable. Honestly, my goal as a kid growing up was to try and win one national event in each of the years I competed. And, you know, I've been very fortunate, very blessed. My father, Jeg, and everyone at Jeg's. And over the years, we've had so many great wins. But fast forward to today, how about this elite team? And my hot rod really came around now this weekend. We changed some things out on Saturday, and the car started accelerating really well. And these last two rounds, this thing was on a rail, and it felt great. I didn't even see my wind light come on there, so I was a little bit bummed. You know, the next 1,500 feet as I was pulling off, I was excited but also bummed. But, you know, congrats to the whole team, man. It's everyone at Skag Power Equipment, Outlaw Beer, Jeg's, JHG. Man, we love y'all. Hello to my family back home in Ohio. I love you. Miss you.
The final of Nitro Funny Car at the Northwest Nationals. Tire smoke for Paul Lee and a wind light for Austin Prock. Man, this kid is just unbelievable. A 69 reaction time. His brother Thomas pumps his fist. 387.5 at 334.57 miles an hour. It is a bulldozer, man. That is a bulldozer.
For a rookie funny car driver, he is getting all too accustomed this whole procedure down here as he claims his fourth funny car title. You know, Austin Prock, you and I talked back in the pits, and you said, I've been 60, 70 on the tree, and you said, I just need to do my job. You did just that. You won 69. You trusted the car, and you trusted your dad and your brother to give you that Wally here today. How good is it to know that you've got those two men in your corner each and every time you stage up?
It's amazing, man. There's nothing better than racing for family and racing for John Forza. We didn't just win today. We doubled up with John Force again here in Seattle. He told me before I got in here, he said, hold the fort down for me, and we did just that. So just an amazing day, another great day for this Cornwell Tools Chevrolet Camaro SS. I mean, this year's just been unreal, man. I can't even, like, put into words all the success that we've had. It's just been a blur, and I've just been hanging on. And I wasn't leaving that great all weekend, but I sure was consistent. I was 67, 67, 69, 69. So all stayed shallow, and man, woo! Yeah.
And it did. He was out first. He was ahead of Langdon at the finish line stripe. It is Steve Torrence for the first time in a calendar year. A 3.96 to an engine expiring 4.17 for Sean Langdon. Steve Torrence has finally broken through again.
Well, the last time four-time world champion Steve Torrence won, he was only a father of one. Now you're a father of two. It has been a full calendar year. I couldn't even tell by the celebration that you were excited. Talk about that run for you, because you had a lot going on in that car.
Man, I'll tell you what. You know, you take these things for granted when you get them pretty often. And we're taking this one home to my new baby girl. My wife's birthday. We've been a while. Hell, I'm out of breath. I didn't do nothing but hit the gas like three times. Sean Langdon, Khalid Air, those guys been bad to the bone. I told you earlier I was trying to take him out all day. But these Capco boys, Redline Oil, Toyota, Mack Tools, we don't have a lot of partners, but the ones we do, we think highly of, and they're the best. This is pretty cool, man. 1 year to the date. I was kind of thinking we wasn't going to be able to win one of these for a while. And Richard Hogan, Bobby, sometimes us Torrences are hard to deal with, but them guys handle us pretty good, and thank you guys. How about all those guys at home from Capco that are keeping us out here? We appreciate y'all.